Thank you very much. Thank you to the advocates, the DSPs, and the autism and intellectual disability community to bringing this issue to our attention. I think it's incredibly important that we be transparent when we address this issue today. I've had numerous conversations with our community organization and service providers, and here's the reality. These providers are reporting crisis levels of understaffing due to inadequate funding. One specific organization reported that they currently have 300 job openings and no one to fill them because they cannot offer competitive wages. Direct service providers are essential to the health and well-being of our loved ones in the intellectual disability and autism community. That they receive services to improve their quality of life, to provide dignity, compassion, and critical care to those who need it is essential. However, we provide very little of this dignity and compassion in return of their hard work. They put the hustle in during the pandemic without a complaint. And what did we give them? Nothing. It is time. These individuals are dedicated caretakers. They work long hours for low wages and are given extraordinary responsibility. We expect this workforce to commute to our districts, but we do not pay them enough to actually live in the communities they are serving. I am talking about lengthy and costly commutes. I once spoke to a direct service provider who would regularly volunteer for overnight shifts on top of her regular shift, just so that she could cut commuting costs and keep enough of her paycheck in her pocket to support her family and return to work the next day. Minimum wage is not enough to compensate for the work these individuals do. We need to invest in this workforce because an investment in them, those who care for some of our most vulnerable individuals, speaks to our values. I believe this $540 million appropriated in this bill is just the first step to making up ground adequately to fund our DSPs. Thank you very much.